Thank you. Mr. Speaker, I ask unanimous consent that all members may have 5 legislative days within which to revise and extend their remarks and include extraneous materials on H.R. 38.
Without objection.
Mr. Speaker, I yield myself such time as I may consume.
The gentleman is recognized.
I rise in strong support of H.R. 38, the Concealed Carry Reciprocity Act of 2017.
The House will be in order. Gentlemen may resume.
Mr. Speaker, throughout my career in elected office, I have believed in and adhered to 2 fundamental principles regarding firearms policy. First, the right guaranteed to law-abiding Americans by the Second Amendment must be aggressively protected and preserved. Second, the laws we have on the books need to be enforced to the fullest extent possible. The bipartisan bill before us today does both. H.R. 38 ensures that law-abiding citizens' Second Amendment right does not end when they cross state lines. Mr. Speaker, the House is not in order.
The House will be in order. Please take all conversations to the cloakrooms or off the floor. The gentleman from Virginia.
The bill allows law-abiding gun owners with valid state-issued concealed carry firearm permits to, or those who live in so-called constitutional carry states, to carry a concealed firearm in any other state that also allows concealed carry. We know that citizens who carry a concealed firearm are not only better prepared to act in their own self-defense, but also in the defense of others. Take, for instance, an incident that occurred just last November on a highway in Florida. Lee County Sheriff's Deputy Dean Bards had just concluded a high-speed chase just off Interstate 75. As Deputy Bards approached to apprehend the suspect, Edward Struther, violently attacked Deputy Bards. A witness on the scene told reporters that the attacker just started punching him and hitting and hitting and hitting. I was afraid for the police officer. I thought he was going to kill him. Fortunately for Deputy Bards, Ashad Russell, a Florida concealed carry permit holder, was also watching the attack unfold. Mr. Russell pulled his gun and approached the altercation. He told Struther he would shoot him if he didn't stop beating the deputy. The state attorney's office says Struther ignored Russell's commands to stop beating the deputy, so Russell fired his gun 3 times, hitting and fatally wounding the assailant. Lee County Sheriff Mike Scott has hailed Russell as a hero. Importantly, this bill also contains the Fix NICS Act of 2017. This is a bipartisan and bicameral measure. The Fix NICS Act takes steps to ensure that state and federal agencies enter all relevant records into the FBI's National Instant Criminal Background Check System. This bill will help ensure people who are legally prohibited from having guns, like those with violent felony convictions, do not obtain them. The shooting at Virginia Tech and the church shootings in Charleston, South Carolina, and Sutherland Springs, Texas, are tragic reminders of what can happen when all relevant records are not entered into the system. Our NICS system is only as good as the information within it. This important piece of legislation will ensure that more of the information already required to be uploaded to NICS under current law is actually placed in the NICS system. Taken together, the Concealed Carry Reciprocity Act and the Fix NICS Act preserve and protect the right guaranteed to us by the Second Amendment and ensure that those prohibited by existing law from receiving a firearm are prevented from doing so. I urge my colleagues to join me in supporting this legislation. I want to thank the lead sponsor, Mr. Hudson of North Carolina, for his hard work on this bill. And I would also like to thank the authors of the Fix NICS provisions, Mr. Culberson and Mr. Cuellar, for their important contributions to the legislation before us today. And I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman